just another punk. I am the punk dog child, man. Punk.
Them other girls you done been with, none of them got nothing on me. Ain't got my style, they ain't got nothing on me, nothing on me. Where I walk, where I talk, my swagger. Look around, every dude wanna have her. I ain't saying that I'm the best, but I'm the best. Hey baby, you need that. Stop looking for,
for me, it comes from like seeing it every day, seeing thin people around me.
Because I think society, we're so obsessed with looking good and being thin.
Because models are pretty and models are skinny.
Because you look better in clothes, you're skinnier, and you're more confident normally. So yeah.
Because regardless of whether or not people want to admit fat people aren't attractive, to the vast majority of people in our world today, and being thin is usually associated with being beautiful and healthy and everything a girl would want to be. I think it's just something that's naturally thought of as something that's better. Who wants to be fat? Who wants to be thin?
I mean, I think a lot of it is media pressure, and just, yeah, no, the media. Totally the media.
I think it's the media, but, like, because, like, everyone else, everyone that's pretty in the world is generally skinny.
Well, I think the overwhelming pressure comes from social media. You look at the most beautiful women in the world today, and they're slim. And even when they're not slim, there's a lot of editing that takes place to make them look better than they actually are.
Media makes it like that.
Seeing it in media, definitely makes me feel like that's what it's in.
I would definitely say that models are portrayed a lot more. But I would say that media portrays them as just as healthy as athletes. But athletes are never really, like, shed in the light.
I think just the media we see every day, definitely models. And I don't always think that athletes have that body type that the media looks for and wants to portray.
I definitely think that models are portrayed more, and when athletes are portrayed, they typically are now portrayed in a more sexualized way. So you're not going to see like the muscular athletes in the media. You're more going to see like the thin, pretty athletes. So thin and being pretty, and I mean, like, they're definitely chosen more for their appearance rather than their athletic ability when they're chosen for ads or different things.
Models. What do you mean?
Probably models. Yeah, I think models, just because they're thinner, and I feel like that's what people want to see. They want to see people who are thinner and like in shape. And like if you're an athlete, sometimes you can be a little bit more muscular, and I feel like that's viewed as like not as attractive, which I personally think is lame.
The women in these photographs are incredibly brave to share their stories and the intimate details of their private struggles with a tragic illness. These women decided that by being honest with the camera, they could possibly make a difference for themselves and for others. Stephanie, a 14-year-old from Texas, tells her story about calorie counting and the pressures from ballet, friends, and family. Stephanie discusses the early development of her eating disorder at the young age of 10. Her best friend and her both developed eating disorders at the same time and competed for the skinniest body for years until Stephanie got help. Stephanie tells Greenfield that her friend, who did not seek help, is continuing with her bulimia.
Shelley, a 25-year-old from Salt Lake City, begins her story discussing her 10 hospitalizations, nose tube for eating, which she had for 5 years straight, and now stomach tube for forced feeding. Shelley's story, accompanied by pictures of her emancipated body, is full of denial and refusal. She describes her constant self-hatred while in rehab and feels filthy and pig-like when she has calories in her body. She admits she finds ways to remove the food in her stomach with a syringe herself. She used to work in a hospital, and she explains her shame in being hospitalized now.
Kathy, a 48-year-old from New York, complains about having a broken body, no teeth, little hair, and no good leg. Her age alone is shocking, but her story is even more disturbing. Kathy has lost absolutely everything from her eating disorder, and she's still not well. Losing her husband, family, and health has been a downward spiral for Kathy, and she just can't seem to recover. Unlike most, her eating disorder was developed later in life. She fell under stress and turned to an eating disorder as a way to control.
Every girl is affected by the desire to be thin. In the United States, we grew up feeling like our bodies are an expression of our inner selves. To be thin is to be beautiful, disciplined, and even moral. Fat is equated with laziness, a lack of regard for oneself, and a deficiency of self-control.